ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ओम वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं। हरि ओम। इन दिस वर्ल्ड ऑल ऑफ अस प्ले डिफरेंट रोल्स इन अवर लाइफ। एवरी वन ऑफ अस हैज गॉट डिफरेंट फैसेट्स। फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ अ मैन इज सीन बाय हिज ओन सन as a loving father, the same person is seen as a strict boss in his office. His wife sees him as a good husband. In the same way, when we go to Dwapara Yuga, Lord Krishna was seen as a wonder boy in Vrindavan. In the Bhagavad Gita itself, we can see him in various aspects as a world class teacher, Jagadguru, universal teacher, as Ishvara, the Lord himself, and as the self of all. In the first chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was very confident to fight. In fact, even Duryodhana was frightened. In the beginning, Arjuna was very confident and he asked Krishna, please keep my chariot between the two armies. Senayor ubhayor madhye mama ratham sthapaya. He was eager to see who are all wanted to fight with him. But at the time, Lord Krishna took the chariot and placed exactly in front of Bhishma and Dronacharya. Here we should think properly. Why should Krishna place the chariot exactly in front of Bhishma and Dronacharya? Why not in front of Duryodhana? Why not in front of Karna or any other warrior? Here we can see in Krishna the perfect teacher, because Lord Krishna wanted to test the psychological condition, the mental strength of Arjuna before the war itself. Because in the middle of the war, if Arjuna's mind becomes weak, then it is going to be very difficult. It is going to be very problem. Therefore, for example, sometimes when we go for a journey, when we want to travel by a car, before the journey, we check our car condition. Whether fuel is there or not, whether brakes are working properly or not, everything. Otherwise, in the middle of the journey, if something happens, then we are going to land in the problem. Same way, here Krishna wanted to see the condition of Arjuna. How does he face his own guru, his own great grandfather? As expected, as soon as Arjuna saw his own guru, when he saw his own Pitamaha, Bhishma Pitamaha, then he started shivering. Then he said, Nakanche Vijayam Krishna Nacharajam Sukhanicha. Krishna, I don't want this kingdom. I don't want to fight because I see my own guru, my own great grandfather, my own brothers, my own children. Here, please understand. Arjuna was overpowered by mamatva bhavana, my own, my own, my own. He forgot that he is the warrior. He forgot that he is the soldier and he has to stand by the righteousness. He has to stand by dharma. And he was almost in the condition of sorrow, shoka. This sorrow was caused because of moha. Moha, lack of right thinking, lack of knowledge. So, Lord Krishna diagnosed the disease perfectly. Then he wanted to cure. See, when a patient goes to a doctor, first, diagnosis is most important aspect. Without the diagnosis, how can you cure? What medicine can you give? Same way. Now, the Arjuna's problem, the Arjuna's condition is, he was overpowered by karpanya dosha, kurpanatva bhava, the mamatva bhava, my own people. And you know, but Arjuna is covering with logical argument. When we look at Arjuna's argument, it is so wonderful that if some other person is there in the place of Krishna, he would have been convinced and he would have told that, okay Arjuna, what you said is right, let's give up this war, let's go. That was the argument given by Arjuna. He said, if we kill our gurus, our grandparents, we will go to Naraka. Because of this war, all Kula Dharmas, entire the society will collapse. And even our ancestors will fall down. Lupta Pindodaka Kriyaha. It is a perfect argument by Arjuna, but which is not relevant here. So, knowing the condition of Arjuna, Lord Krishna gave him a shock treatment first. Kutastva kashmalame. Saying that you are behaving like a eunuch. Just to bring him from the state of sorrow. Then slowly Lord Krishna started teaching him the Atma Jnana, Sankhya Yoga. But knowing the nature of Arjuna, Arjuna being a Kshatriya warrior, he is a man of action. Always he wanted to work. He wanted to achieve success in life. Such a person, when he is taught the Atma Jnana, then Krishna came down to the level of Arjuna and started teaching him Karma Yoga. Because through Karma Yoga only his mind can be purified. And that purified mind only can get the knowledge of self. So, Lord Krishna gave him step by step. Karma Yoga, through Karma Yoga, we get purified, we get Chitta Shuddhi, Chitta Ekagrata, and from that Chitta Shuddhi, we get qualification for Sankhya Yoga. And in the second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, if we see what a transformation Krishna brought in Arjuna. In the beginning of the second chapter, Arjuna was in such a pitiable condition that he could not even stand on the chariot. But when it comes to almost 54th sloka of the second chapter, the personality, the mindset of Arjuna has changed and he started asking questions.
Sthita prajnasya ka bhasha samadhistasya keshava.
This was the first question asked by Arjuna after he got deluded, after he gave up, he wanted to give up the war. What a transformation. That's why Krishna is a world-class teacher. Understanding the condition of the student, the capacity of the student, Arjuna started teaching him. Then Lord Krishna was praising the Sankhya Yoga. At the end of the second chapter, he said,
Yesha Brahmi Sthiti Partha Nainam Prapya Vimuhyate.
O Arjuna, by gaining this Brahmi Sthiti, this state of perfection, then you will be released from this bondage. Again, sometimes, you know, in our life also, sometimes we get inspiration. Yes, we want to walk this path of spirituality. After the satsang, we get a lot of inspiration. But again, after 2 days, 3 days, this inspiration goes down. Now, like that, Arjuna also got inspiration. He said, I will also follow this path of jnana. I don't want to fight again. I want to give up this war. I will go to forest and I will meditate. That's why he asked, O Krishna, you are praising the path of jnana again. Why are you forcing me to do karma? Because without purification of our mind, we cannot sit quietly. Therefore, karma yoga is the means and sankhya yoga is the goal. Sankhya yoga is the means, atmajnana, self-realization is the goal. This is the way, this is the ladder. Such a wonderful teaching, such a methodology Lord Krishna taught to Arjuna. And nowadays in the modern world, as we get many doubts, Arjuna also got a doubt. O Krishna, you are saying in the yoga, we should sit with mind focused, single pointed, keeping the goal in our mind. But chancharam hi manah Krishna. Our mind is always fickle minded. It never keeps one as the goal. It goes on wandering. It is very difficult. Then what should I do? The same doubt what we get nowadays. Or sometimes Arjuna got a doubt also. Okay, right, I chose this path, I wanted to walk in this path of spirituality, in this path of jnana marga or karma yoga marga. But if I fail to achieve the goal, if I can't reach that goal, what would be my condition? In this worldly life also, I don't get success, nor in the spiritual life. The same doubt nowadays many of us have got. Krishna, though he taught Bhagavad Gita 5,000 years ago, that is applicable even today. The same doubt expressed by Arjuna, most of us also have the same doubt. My mind is not able to concentrate. What if I don't achieve my goal? Then Krishna never discouraged. Lord Krishna said, yes, asamshayam mahabhavo, what you said is right. It is difficult, but it is possible through abhyasa and vairagya. And even if the person doesn't reach the goal, but his efforts don't go waste at all. Like this, Arjuna was taught by the Lord himself, Krishna. And at the end of the Bhagavad Gita, in the 18th chapter, we can see Arjuna saying, Nashto moha smrutir labdha tvat prasadan maya achyuta. Hey Achyuta, O Krishna, now my moha is gone. Nashta. Smrutir labdha. I got that smruti. Earlier I was dharma sammoda cheta. I was in a confused state what to do. But now, sthitosmi gata sandeha. Now my doubts are gone. Now karishye vachanam tava. From this we can understand the transformation brought in the personality of Arjuna. From the state where he could not able to think anything, and now he did not say, Krishna, I didn't understand anything, please repeat. He never said like that. So Lord Krishna is seen as a world-class teacher, Jagadguru, universal teacher in the Bhagavad Gita. Okay, in the second aspect, Lord Krishna, he is none other than Ishvara, the Lord himself. No, I have doubt. How do you say that Krishna is the Lord Ishvara? We may get that doubt. Because at one point of time, even Arjuna also got that doubt. In the fourth chapter, Krishna Paramatma said, Arjuna, the knowledge what I taught you, it was taught to the sun, Surya, long ago. Then immediately Arjuna got it out. Aparam bhavato janma, param janma vivasvatah. How can you say that, Krishna? You belong to this time, this period of time, whereas Surya is ancient. Arjuna had the sandeha, doubt. Same way we also, how can we say that Krishna is the God? First of all, now we are discussing about Bhagavad Gita. In this, many places, Vedavyasji said, Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Vedavyasji did not say, Vasudeva Vacha. Always, that Rishi referred him, Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Bhagavan, Lord himself. When Vedavyasji could say he is the Lord himself, after all, who are we? Okay, now logically if we think, who is Ishvara? Ishvara, in simple words, Ishvara is the one who takes care of Srushti, Sthiti, Laya. Means, Ishvara is the one from whom the all beings, the whole world emerges. From him, everything should come. Srushti, creator of this world.
Ishvara is the one who sustains. It's not just creation alone. Ishvara is the one who sustains. And Ishvara is the one into whom the entire world dissolves. Now, when we look at Bhagavad Gita, how is the Krishna seen as the Lord Ishvara? In the 7th chapter, there is a famous shloka. Matta parataram nanyato kinchidasti dhananjaya mai sarvamidam protam sutre maniganayiva. Mayi, in me, sarvamidam protam sutre maniganayiva. Just as the pearls are strung in a thread, same way, he is pervaded throughout this world, throughout this universe. And it is said in the 7th chapter itself, Aham Krishnasya Jagataha Prabhava Pralayastatha Jagataha Krishna Prabhavaha Pralayahapi. He is the one from whom this Jagat world is emerging. He is the one into whom this world again dissolves into. So, then how can you say he is the protector, he is the sustainer? Okay, from him this world is coming. He said, Matta parataram nanyato prabhavaha. Prabhavaha, from where it is emerging. There are famous shlokas in the Bhagavad Gita. See, this world is always sustained by dharma. Dharayate iti dharma. Bhagavan, Lord, as dharma, sustains this world. A system of dharma, a system of functioning. Dharayate, that which sustains is called dharma. Therefore, Bhagavan said, Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata. Whenever there is a decline of dharma, then Bhagavan, he himself takes the manifestation and he sets it right. Just as in the world, if a company produces a product, a machine, or if a company manufactures a computer, if some problem comes in the computer, that manufacturer, he comes down to repair it because he gave warranty and he repairs. Same way, Bhagavan should come down to sustain, to protect. He exactly, Bhagavan, he himself exactly said this. And also, he is the one who takes care of all our yoga kshema. Yoga kshemam vahamyam. He, in fact, Bhagavan is the one who is giving us everything, the energy, or the food, or the life, everything. He is looking after our yoga kshema. Okay, so Bhagavan is the one who is creating. Bhagavan, the Lord, Krishna is the one who is sustaining, the protecting this world. And Krishna, he is also seen as the one who, into whom the entire world is dissolving. In the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, again Krishna said, कालोस्मि लोकक्षय प्रवृद्ध लोकान् समाहर्तुमिह प्रवृत्त। इन द फॉर्म ऑफ काला, काला द टाइम, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ काला ऑल दीज लोक लोकक्षय प्रवृद्ध all in the time all worlds are again dissolved into the same paramatma or same ishvara, the lord himself. So in this way lord krishna is seen as a jagadguru, a world class teacher, and also lord krishna is seen as the ishvara himself. Now the third aspect, Krishna is seen as the self of all beings. Finally, at the end of our life, at the end of our sadhana, we realize that Krishna, he is none other than the self in all of us.
सर्वभूतस्थमात्मानं सर्वभूतानि चात्मनि।
भगवान हिमसेल्फ, कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ सेड इन द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर ऑफ भगवद्गीता,
यो मां पश्यति सर्वत्र सर्वं च मयि पश्यति।
हूएवर सीज ऑल बीइंग्स इन द सेल्फ and the self in all beings, and again in the next shloka itself we said, whoever sees me everywhere and whoever sees everything in me, which means Bhagavan himself is everywhere, Bhagavan is in all beings, and all beings are in Bhagavan. Bhagavan is in all beings and all beings are in Bhagavan means Bhagavan is in me, I am in Bhagavan, the Lord, as the self. So by realizing this as the self, the one saha yogi mayi vartate, he just merges into Bhagavan. Brahmavid Brahmaiva Bhavati, the one who understood himself as the Atma, here understanding Atma means he becomes one with the Atma, he is the Atma self alone. So in this way Lord Krishna as the Guru, as the Ishvara, as the self, as it is rightly said,
ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने।
It's only then what is the difference between guru, atma, ishvara? So only upadhi difference, that's all, only upadhi difference. He is the guru, krishna is the guru, krishna is ishvara, krishna is the self. And when we realize the true nature of Bhagavan, we become one with Bhagavan. As it is rightly said in the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita,
mayeva mana adhasva maye buddhim niveshaya nivashishyasi mayeva ata urdham na samshayah.
In our sadhana, if we keep our mind, mayeva mana adhasva, our mind in Bhagavan himself, in Bhagavan alone, in the Lord alone, mayi buddhim niveshaya, keeping our intellect, buddhi, in Bhagavan alone,
nivasishyasi mayeva,
all our mind, all our thoughts, all our energies, we just live in that spirit. Always live in that thought alone.
Atavurdham na samshayah,
there is no doubt. Definitely we reach that place, that abode, supreme abode. That is our own self, the self-realization. Hari Om.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.